I'm Dr. Katie Landier, the Senior Centered Physical Therapist, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be doing exercises to help decrease golfer's elbow pain, or even prevent golfer's elbow if it's not something you're currently dealing with. If you do have golfer's elbow, you know that it's very painful and may be keeping you from what you really love to do. So this video is designed to give you exercises and tips you can use daily to help decrease your pain and improve your function. In this video, I'll demonstrate about one set of each exercise, but for complete reps and set recommendations, please see my blog, theseniorcenteredpt.com. Let's talk about what you'll need for this video. So first, a small ball, like a Franklin ball that has some squish to it, and a table or a stable surface that you can rest your arm, and a mat or a bed where you can lie down. Before we go any further, I kindly ask that you give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button in order to get notified when I have any new content. Also, please visit and subscribe to my blog, theseniorcenteredpt.com, for more information on golfer's elbow and many other topics that impact older adults. Let's start by taking a look at all of the muscles we will be working in this video. Let's first look at where golfer's elbow originates. So it's caused by overuse of the hand and wrist flexor muscles, and they attach to the medial epicondyle, which is part of the humerus. So that's why you get that inner elbow pain. Golfer's elbow, though, isn't unique to golfers. Other athletes, tennis players, or just individuals whose work requires repeated prolonged flexion movements of the hand and wrist can experience golfer's elbow. So it's important for everyone to maintain good strength and flexibility of the forearms and upper body as a whole to prevent overuse injuries. So for this video, for our muscle rolling and tapping, our wrist flexor stretch, our wrist flexion isometrics, we're going to focus on the flexors of the hand and wrist. So flexor digitorum superficialis, and deep to that, flexor digitorum profundus. For our extensor stretch, we're going to be stretching the back of the arm. So that's going to be extensor carpi radialis brevis, extensor carpi radialis longus, extensor digitorum, extensor carpi ulnaris, and extensor digiti minimi. For our open books and angels in the snow, these exercises focus on mobility of the thoracic spine, so middle of the spine there, as well as the shoulder girdle to enable improved upper body functioning so that the forearm doesn't have to take on more work than it actually should. For our scapular retractions, this exercise also promotes overall upper body strength, and the muscles targeted here are our rhomboids as well as our trapezius. That's all the muscles we'll be targeting in this video. Let's get started. So with any exercise, we want to make sure we get in a good warm-up to make sure our muscles aren't too cold before we try to stretch them. So a good way to do that is to use this ball. So this is a Franklin ball that you can get on Amazon, but it's nice and squishy. So you can use a tennis ball, but sometimes that's just a little bit too hard. But what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna place the ball on my table, and then I'm gonna place my forearm on the ball and give it just a little pressure. And then I'm just gonna roll. So I'm just rolling back and forth to kind of find spots that are sore. And as I find that spot that's sore, I can pause on it and just do a little flexion and extension of the wrist. And then I can keep moving along, finding these sore spots. So this should just feel kind of like a nice little massage. You can also feel free to do this on the other side. I always recommend doing exercises on both sides just to even yourself out and make sure that you're preventing any golfer's elbow on that opposite side. If this is too much pressure, another way you can do this is by tapping. So you take that ball and you just gently tap up and down that forearm, kind of in those same sore spots, just to give yourself a little bit of that relief. Whichever version you choose to do of this, you're just gonna do this for about 2 minutes and then take a little rest, and then you can take your time to do the other side as well. For our next exercise, we're gonna do our wrist flexion isometrics. Isometrics are designed to allow for the muscles to contract, but there's no real change in length of the muscle or movement at the joint. So these allow for us to build strength without providing any excess stress at the joint. So for this, I'm gonna put my affected arm on the table, palm face up, and then I'm gonna make a fist. And then I'm gonna use my other hand as my resistance. So then I try to flex my lower hand there, and I'm not gonna get a whole lot of movement, and that's okay. My top hand's really the resistance, and you can see how I get that little isometric contraction there in the wrist. So I hold that for about 10 seconds, and then gently release, and release my hand, and we can give a little shake out, and then you can do that again. Next, we're gonna do a few stretches. So we're gonna do our wrist flexor stretch. So I'm just gonna straighten my arm out in front, palm facing up, and then take my opposite hand and just press those straight fingers down towards the floor. So I get a nice stretch, the front part of that forearm there. And you just wanna breathe. So not holding your breath during stretches, allowing everything to relax. And you'll hold that for about 30 seconds. And then after 30 seconds, you gently release and then repeat it on the opposite side. And I would do this 2 times on each side. Next is our wrist extensor stretch. So we're gonna put our hand out, palm facing down this time, and then use that opposite hand to just press those straight fingers down towards the floor. Now you're stretching the other side of that arm. Once again, we're just gonna hold that for 30 seconds, and it shouldn't be painful. You should just feel that stretch in the arm. If it's any pain, we can just gently release a little bit. So you'll hold for 30 seconds. After that 30 seconds, release and repeat it on the other side. For the next exercises, I'm gonna get up onto my mat table. So you can either grab your mat or you can use your bed, but just find a place where you can lay down comfortably. For open books, we're just laying on our side and we're making sure that our knees and our ankles are stacked together. Then I'm gonna take my top hand and I'm just gonna reach it up and over. So my chest is now pointing towards the ceiling and my bottom shoulder here stays on the mat. My top shoulder, if it doesn't touch the mat, that's totally fine. What we're doing here is we're getting nice rotation in that thoracic spine, and this is gonna help for mobility in the spine, but also the shoulder girdle, so we don't have any excess motion being done at the forearm, which can cause pain. You hold this for about 30 seconds, take a big breath, and then bring that hand back to the starting position. And then you'll roll over and do it on the other side. I'm gonna move right into our next exercise, which is angels in the snow. So we're gonna roll onto our back here. So we're gonna keep our knees and feet stacked, and then we're just gonna let them rotate to one side. And then the opposite arm is gonna reach overhead. If you can, you can look towards that opposite hand. If that's too much on your neck, you can just look towards the ceiling. But we just wanna get that full rotation through the body, letting the legs be nice and heavy and allowing for thoracic mobility and movement of the shoulder girdle to allow for relaxation of that forearm. Breathing the whole time, hold for about 30 seconds, and then you'll lift the knees back up to center and the hand comes down. Lastly, we'll do our scapula retractions so we can move off of our mat or bed. For our last exercise, we're gonna be doing our scapular retractions. So once again, this is an upper body movement to really help loosen up the shoulders and make sure that the forearm's not taking over and doing more work than necessary. So the big thing with scapular retractions is just making sure it's the scapula or the shoulder blades moving rather than the arms. So I'll show you from the front and the back so you can see what it looks like. So from the front, I'm just bringing the shoulder blades together and you can see my arms are moving a little bit, but I don't have this excessive arm movement. It's really subtle. So when I move my shoulder blades together in the back, the collarbones widen. And then when I release them, the collarbones kind of narrow. So just really subtle motion in the front. You'll do this about 10 times and then take your rest and remember to repeat it for about 3 sets. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope these exercises help to decrease your pain and restore your function. Please feel free to comment below on how these exercises helped you. Also, remember to hit that like button and subscribe so you can help others find my channel and receive notifications for all future content. Until next time, I'm Dr. Katie Landier, the Senior-Centered Physical Therapist. Have the strength to live life to the fullest. Bye-bye.